Good afternoon. I know you've been waiting in joyful expectation for the news on consultations. So this afternoon, we were briefed by the Special Representative of the Secretary General, Ismail Ould Sheikh Ahmed, on the situation in Yemen. The council members urged the parties in the conflict to endeavor to resolve their differences through dialogue, because a military solution to the conflict is not attainable. We stress that only a political solution will lead to a viable peace. Council members agreed the need for access for humanitarian goods and services and supplies, as this will be an essential early step towards peace. Council members expressed support for the efforts of Special Envoy Ahmed and encouraged all parties to cooperate with him in the quest for a peaceful resolution to the conflict. I must add that there was absolute consensus on these elements that I've just read out to you.
Was there any discussion of these talks? These talks that have taken place in Oman between the envoy and the Houthis? The Yemeni permanent representative said that they don't recognize them. But did it come up in the council? And can you say anything about tomorrow's sexual abuse and UN peacekeeping missions session? What time will it be? Will it be open? And what do you expect to come out of it?
I will only address Yemen for now. Well, I raised the critical and pivotal role of the region in the peace process, but there were no further discussions on that because I believe it's ongoing. Yes. Thank you.
On Yemen, did you discuss any monitoring mechanism to implement the resolution 2216? Because this is obviously one of the elements that will Sheikh is discussing.
Yes, we recognize, a few delegates recognize the importance of the monitoring mechanism, but there was no conclusion to that. It's a process. Thank you. Can I now brief you on Guinea-Bissau? I know you've been very, very expectant too. And the reason that this was delayed was because we were expecting some interventions from that region. And now that we have a clearer picture, I thought I should read out this press statement on the situation in Guinea-Bissau. You know that we met on the 10th of August, and the council was briefed by Tayé-Brook Zerihoun, the Assistant Secretary General for Political Affairs, on the situation in Guinea-Bissau. The members of the Security Council took note of the ongoing tension between the President and the Prime Minister, which threatens to undermine the progress made in Guinea-Bissau since the restoration of constitutional order following the elections in 2014. We underscored that the Guinea-Bissau people deserve stable, inclusive, and operative institutions that act in the best interests of all people of Guinea-Bissau. The members of the council called on all Guinea-Bissau's political leadership, including the President and the Prime Minister, to resume dialogue in order to work together concertedly in the governance of Guinea-Bissau as it emerges from previous periods of instability. The members of the council reemphasized the importance of political stakeholders to engage in continuous and constructive dialogue within the established constitutional parameters. The members of the council recall Resolution 2203 of 2015 and stress the importance of national reconciliation, inclusive dialogue and governance, and continued civilian control of government as essential for the attainment of lasting peace in Guinea-Bissau. We further stress that the consolidation of peace and stability in Guinea-Bissau can only result from a consensual, inclusive, and nationally owned process, and respect for constitutional order that places Guinea-Bissau and its people first. The members of the Council welcomed ongoing efforts of regional and international actors, including ECOWAS, the African Union, the United Nations, and its Guinea-Bissau Peace Building Commission, the CPLP, and the EU, to encourage dialogue among Guinea-Bissau's political leadership. We particularly welcome the efforts of Senegalese President Sall, Guinea President Condé, and Special Representative of the Secretary General and Head of UNOGBIS, Trovada, in this regard. The members of the Security Council recall the Council's commitment to support the authorities of Guinea-Bissau and note that the pledges made at the March 2015 Brussels International Donor Conference require a stable political environment in order to most effectively materialize. The members of the Council commended the peaceful way that the population of Guinea-Bissau, including its civil society and the military, are following the political situation in the country. The last sentence implies that they are watching with keen interest rather than going out on the streets. Thank you.
On Guinea-Bissau, I know that ECOWAS and the Lusophone group, CPLP, have you know, sometimes worked together, sometimes some difference of opinion. With Angola now on the Council, is everything working smooth? Are both groups working toward the same end in Guinea-Bissau?
You're very perceptive. I believe that things are smoother now than they were 2 years ago. We seem to have a semblance of an orchestra playing a symphony in this case. Thank you.